look at this little news item plopping into her lap on a Monday. Jake McCabe is a Leaf, and he's going to continue to be that for the next half decade. The Toronto Maple Leafs have signed Jake McCabe to a 5-year deal that will pay him a cap hit of $4.51 million, but it's actually way more confusing. Let's get complicated than simplified. Here is the full breakdown according to Puckpedia. From Puckpedia, McCabe, 5 years, $23.5 million must be nice. Now they break down every year, the base salary, the signing bonus. Here's all that matters. I mean, really all that, all those specific details, they matter for Jake McCabe. They don't matter for us. Cash paid is $4.7 million average, but the cap hit with deferrals, yeah, the Leafs are getting involved in that game, $4.51 million. In years 1 and 2 of the contract, there's a no trade clause. Years 3 through 5, there's a 16 team no trade. So basically a full no trade for the first 2 years. And then for 3, 4, and 5, it's half the league. Now, I know what some of you are thinking. How the heck did Jake McCabe get a no trade? And buddy, you are gonna lose it when you go and look at David Kampf's Puckpedia page. Pause the video if you have to. Okay, are you back? Did I ruin your day? I'm sorry. You had to learn somehow. So again, $4.51 million contract, but he's getting paid $4.7 million. So basically with deferrals, which is basically kicking money down the road, think Shohei Ohtani, except way less money. It's about $200,000 a season. That is significant savings on the cap. Now, it's going out there that the Leafs are going to get dinged big time on year 6 of this contract because the money that is getting deferred in his contract, well, it's going somewhere. It's going down the line. Where's the cap hit going to be down the line? Poor CJ, poor Chris Johnson has been trying to explain it to the entire SDPN group chat for like an hour. That's not true, like 15 minutes. And I don't get it. But I've seen numbers as high as, oh, in year 6, there's going to be a $5.5 million cap hit against the Leafs. As I understand it, and I'm willing to be wrong on this, there's no extra cap hit. Now, this strategy kind of found its way onto the forefront when Seth Jarvis signed his extension with Carolina and he had deferred salary in there. And we were all like, since when have you been able to do that? And I was alarmed to find out 2005. Even more alarmed to find out there were other examples of teams doing this, including Carolina. But were they as significant as Seth Jarvis's? Well, no. And that's why it became this big thing. Now that Toronto's doing it, I'm positive everyone's gonna have a problem with it. Not that people didn't have a problem when Carolina did it, it's just you hate the Leafs more. Now there's a brand new Chris Johnston show coming later today. I'm excited to listen to that breakdown, how it all happened. I'm getting teased about it right now. I haven't even heard it. Listen, if you're Jake McCabe or his agent or his family, all that stuff matters to you. Here's all that matters. 5 years kicks in at the beginning of next year. He's obviously under contract for this year. That's why he's been playing games. And next year, when the contract extension kicks in, $4.51 million against the cap. Jake McCabe just turned 31 a few weeks ago, which means this will take him to year 36. And boy, is the Leafs cap structure starting to look a lot like Calgary's when Brad left. You get signed into your mid to late 30s, and you get signed into your mid to late 30s, including the entire D-Core, basically. Morgan Riley signed well into his 30s. OEL is signed well into his 30s. Jake McCabe is signed well into his 30s. Chris Tanev is going to be a Leaf until he's like, what, 42? I mean, I think it starts with a 4. Now, I mean, who am I to talk? I'm as old as Jake McCabe is going to be at the end of his contract, but also, I don't play for the Leafs. Now, I went back and looked at the 2019 Blues because they're a very relevant team to the Leafs all of a sudden because that's the team that Craig Berube won the cup with. And I was like, I wonder if they had a really old D-core. And the answer is no. Jay Bouwmeester was the oldest guy at 34 years old, and Carl Gunnarsson was over 30, and that's about it. Yeah, you forgot Carl Gunnarsson was a Blue. I know, this is another thing to be depressed about. Is $4.51 million against the cap, with the cap going up and up and up every year, a reasonable cap hit for Jake McCabe? Yeah. A lot of Leaf fans forget because he's $2 million against the cap for the team right now. He actually makes $4 million a year. It's that the Chicago Blackhawks retained half on his deal. Low key, like, one of the most underrated moves of Dubas's tenure. Like, it was really good. Like, not only did he get a pretty decent player in Jake McCabe and something who provided something that they lacked, but also they got the Blackhawks to retain the season they got him, the season after they got him, and the season after they got him. They also got Sam Lafferty in the deal, and they wrecked that. They got a fifth rounder, I think. McCabe is a player with warts, absolutely. Does he occasionally blow an assignment or have a giveaway? Sure. I mean, he's a defenseman. He is pretty thoroughly, just second pair. You know he's going to be second pair every game unless there's a significant injury. Can he play the left? Yeah, pretty good. Can he play the right? Yeah, pretty good. Can he hit? Yeah, pretty good. He can shoot, he can skate, he can move the puck. I wouldn't say he's incredibly good at any of those things. He's just kind of steady back there, and if you cross the blue line the wrong way, he'll kill you. Listen, for the first time in a long time, the Leafs' blue line isn't exactly a concern. Riley Tanev, OEL McCabe, however you combine those four guys, there's your top four. And that's going to be your top four for a while. With your bottom pair being filled out by Simone Benoit and who knows, just a rotating cast. If you need to go out and look for third pair defensemen every year, those guys are available. The guys who are not available are the guys who can play in your top four. And if they are available, they usually make more than $4.5 million. Especially if they can play with both sides and are big and hit to basically decapitate. Legally, of course, all legally. Steve, aren't you concerned about how old he's gonna be at the end of his contract and the salary structure of the D-Core going forward? Yeah, but that's 5 years from now, me's problem, and I haven't even met that guy. I don't even know him. That guy might not even take my advice. He might think I'm a straight-up idiot. And like, as a fan base, we're freaking out about the last 3 games, 9 games into the season. Let's perhaps leave what's gonna happen over 5 years from now alone. He's a good player. It's a good cap hit. I don't fully understand how it got to be that good of a cap hit, but that's CJ's job. And of course, tomorrow, it just so happened to work out this way, Steve Dangle Podcast. What do you think of the Jake McCabe extension? Leave a comment in the comment box down below. But for now, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you liked this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. Being 36 is not old. It's not.